Hello. I'm currently continuing the repair of the 3-meter-long linear motion pair on the surface grinding machine. I've already finished scraping the V-shaped guide prism and have now moved on to the second, flat guideway line. The V-shaped prism currently has a deviation of 5 microns along its entire length, with a smooth sag in the middle. It's late autumn, and temperatures have dropped. Due to challenging circumstances at this facility, the workspace is not heated. The cast iron machine bed has cooled approximately 10 degrees below its normal temperature, while the foundation, being buried a meter into the ground, is less affected by seasonal temperature changes. Consequently, when the cast iron of the bed returns to normal temperature, it will expand slightly relative to the foundation, and the guideway line will straighten. When I finished working on it about a month ago, it was much warmer, and measurements taken with the autocollimator, which are very precise, showed the prism to be perfectly straight. Now, measurements indicate a slight dip of 5 microns in the center. I don't need to make any adjustments, as the geometry will return to its original state in summer. So now I'm beginning to scrape the second, flat guideway line. It is 60 millimeters wide. Like the V-shaped prism, this second, flat guideway line has significant wear from decades of machine operation. The machine itself was manufactured in 1971. Someone even used this surface as an anvil, but fortunately, measurements showed that this area was the highest point on the line, and the anvil section will be removed after scraping. I took the necessary measurements using a level with a sensitivity of 4.5 arc seconds per division, which corresponds to 0.02 millimeters per meter. The level is mounted on a specially assembled stand. I plan to make a separate video on how these measurements were conducted. In this video, I want to show the process of intensive, rough scraping, where a fairly thick layer of cast iron must be removed to compensate for the significant wear on the guideway. I want those interested to see how I do it. I'm not very familiar with Western scraping methods, so there may be some differences from your techniques. Please feel free to discuss this in the comments. My new friend from Hungary, probably noticing how much effort manual scraping requires, sent me a BAX machine as a gift.
Hi, Daniel. I really appreciate it.
But when I was filming the material for this video, I didn't have this machine yet. So, this video will be about intensive scraping, where I need to remove a significant layer of cast iron by hand scraping. The first thing to understand is that I now have what I consider a conditionally perfect, straight V-shaped prism for this situation. I'll make a separate video showing how I take measurements with a 0.2 arc second autocollimator on this V-shaped prism, using a 300 mm mirror stand. This video will confirm the validity of my geometry data. For now, just take it for granted, based on my statement, that it's straight with a tolerance of no more than 5 microns. Measurements taken with the level, based on the straight V-shaped prism, showed the following geometry in the conditional control points I selected for the current tasks, Here are the arbitrary control points T1, T2, T3, and T4. T1 is 0.3 mm higher, T2 is taken as 0, T3 is 0.2 mm higher, T4 is 0.5 mm higher. A few days ago, I scraped the central section between T2 and T3, and now T2 equals 0 mm, T3 equals 0.02 mm. This is sufficient for rough scraping. Now I'm working on the section between T3 and T4. This involves a lot of work. I usually work about 4 hours a day here, as the physical load is considerable, and I have other tasks in the second half of the day. Fortunately, I have plenty of work to do. To maximize efficiency, I frequently sharpen the cutting plates, as a sharp plate only lasts about 5 minutes of actual cutting. After that, performance declines, and I need to resharpen. Regarding how I've adapted to sharpening plates, I should make a separate video. My methods differ slightly from what I've seen from other YouTube authors. I use Soviet-made plates. In the USSR, there was a unique approach to producing carbide components, and these plates are of excellent quality. The hardness is 90 HRC. However, despite this, the plate stays super sharp only for about 100 or 200 intensive cutting strokes. Likely contrary to common practice, I sharpen my blades not only with a radius but also with a straight edge. I alternate between cutting with the radius and the straight edge. I'd like to note that sharpening a blade to a straight edge is not as simple as it may seem, for several reasons. One is that, while the plate's surface may look mirror-like, it's far from perfectly flat. So, I've already leveled the central section between measuring points T2 and T3, they are practically at the same level relative to the V-shaped prism, as confirmed by measurements. The scraping of the surface is still rough since the final scraping will follow this initial stage. My goal with rough scraping is to leave a tolerance of up to 0.03 mm for more precise finishing work. You can see from the straight edge print that the surface between T2 and T3 is approaching flatness. Now that I'm done with this area for the time being, I'm moving on to the section between T3 and T4, where the elevation is the highest, and I need to remove up to half a millimeter. The first step is to make an imprint with the reference surface of the straight edge to understand the current state of the surface and maintain reasonable flatness while removing material. Since I need to remove a lot, I'm cutting with maximum force at the deepest depth possible. Here's the next ink print. Often, I have to cut from an awkward position. Occasionally, I smooth the surface with a flat sharpened blade, which removes prominent high spots left from the round sharpened blade. It's a bit like the function of a wood plane. Periodically, if a significant reduction in surface height is still needed, and the print shows that it's generally flat, I can intensify the material removal. I make a pass with the blade over the high spots, then apply a fresh coat of ink evenly, and perform an intensive cut across the entire surface. Here is the result of such a total blade pass over the surface. As you can see, the damage from using the surface as an anvil has already been completely removed. Now, I'm back to cutting along the ink marks to maintain flatness as closely as possible. Gradually, I'm reducing this section by the specified half millimeter, periodically measuring its relative height to the V-shaped prism. To give you an idea of the pace of this work, here is one of the control measurements. T3 has a height of 0.12 mm, T4, 0.2 mm. This file was recorded at 13:17. Then I cut the cast iron for quite a long time and intensively. When I was quite tired, I made the following measurements of control points T3 and T4 to find out how much I managed to cut off. The next measurements show T3 at 0.08 mm and T4 at 0.15 mm, recorded at 1522. I worked continuously during this time, so on the left, I deepened by 0.04 mm, and on the right, by 0.05 mm in 2 hours. The scraping speed is 0.02 mm per hour, or 0.01 mm every half hour. To manually scrape this section to the specified level will require about 25 hours of work, essentially 3 work shifts. These are the conclusions we can draw from today's session. Thank you for watching, commenting, and liking the video. Special thanks for supporting my channel on Patreon. Stay tuned for more updates, as the work continues. Goodbye.